Thank you for all the CEOs for accepting our request for this our conference. Firstly, we would like to thank to LTT Metal Plastic Recycling Center Berhad, Middle Recycling Center Berhad, Kuala Lumpur Paper Mines for coming for this conversation conference, and we would like to appreciate. Today, we will present our business model canvas to all the CEOs, and we would like to appreciate if you are ready to collaborate with us. I will pass my floor to my... Okay, what we will be doing? We are from SF Sdn Bhd. We will be collaboration with University of Malaysia Pahang, and my partner will explain more about the partners. But I would like to tell you what we're going to do actually. What we're going to do is we are collecting papers from all the universities and living hosts around Pekan. We would like to separate all the papers using the margin and the thickness of the paper, plastics and aluminium, also electronic items, also aluminium. We will separate it, we'll distribute to our runners to deliver to your company, which is we'll make collaboration, and we will make sure that we send all the items in the proper and required ways that you have put SOP for us. This is because we would like to have these ideas is invented when we were doing our OSHA class. We have advised by our lecturer, Madam Katrina, which she has told us, why don't you guys start a model business with the collaboration of sustainability development goals. And we have decided to come out with number 12 SDG, which is responsible consumption and production, no poverty, and also zero hunger, which is all the money that we'll be getting from this program will be distributed.
Okay, thank you for all this information. My question, how many tons are you planning to give us?
We would like to say thank you to Kuala Lumpur Paper Mines CEO, Mr. Yazid. Thank you. We would like to tell you, we haven't put any level or any special targets for the papers, because we know for all the paper mines how many tons that we will give you. Okay, we have planned that we will distribute the paper, we will get the distribution from all university per month. So we haven't set any targets how many tons that all the university need to give us. We will give you, and I'm very sure that every month the weight or the tons will be different. We could not promise you how much we will give you. We won't give you in average or anything. We will see how much we will get, then that much we will distribute to you. Okay, any other questions?
Okay, my question is about how assured are you about the 1 million turnover annually for us? Thank you. Okay, my question is about how assured are you about the 1 million turnover annually for us? Thank you.
Okay, we're back to the proof that we have gotten from Star Online. According to Malaysia Paper
Thank you for the question. According to Malaysian Paper Merchants Association at 2009, Malaysian consumed about 380,000 of waste products. So this value itself, you all can be sure that it can be more than 1 million annual. This is only 1 month. So imagine for 12 months how much you can get. And recycled products will really, really give you good amount and really has a very bright future for the students as well for the companies. That is my point of view and our company's point of view.
As far as we have known, as far as we're concerned, that we have received from Star Online, they have stated that sometimes in Malaysia, you haven't enough of papers till you have import all the papers from outside it, which is we would like to say we strongly believe that we could and we can provide you all the papers. Okay, to the next person, anybody? Guys, open floor.
From the audience.
Thank you. Well, my question is that when you're saying that you guys will provide for the UMP students, for the college community students, and for the HICOM student, so we get it. You are providing us for those ways for the uses of raw materials and all. The question is whether the consequences or disastrous consequences that will happen if somehow, for instance, UMP students and the providers, you guys. So is there any third party involvement between the road section, between us and those you, the providers, or who are responsible for the ones in between us? And who will be responsible for the road section between us, and what will happen, and what we'll do, what are the initiatives that you guys will carry on if anything like that happens? Thank you.
Clap, 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 clap. Excuse me, I think you have misconcept our idea of our company. We are taking the waste product from the university students, from college community and HICOM, we sell it to the companies. Means from CAL or LDT Metal or Mido. So our job is to resell the waste products.
We are the third party.
We are the middleman. Yes, we are the third party. We are not selling anything. We are not recreating any waste products. We take it from the students and we sell it to the company. Okay,
yeah.
Next. Any questions?
Yeah.
But
thank you for the question. According to Malaysian Paper Merchants Association at 2009, Malaysian consumed about 380,000 of waste products. So this value itself, you all can be sure that it can be more than 1 million annual. This is only 1 month. So imagine for 12 months how much you can get. And recycled products will really, really give you good amount and really has a very bright future for the students as well for the companies. That is my point of view and our company's point of view.
As far as we have known, as far as we're concerned, that we have received from Star Online, they have stated that sometimes in Malaysia, you haven't enough of papers till you have import all the papers from outside it, which is we would like to say we strongly believe that we could and we can provide you all the papers. Okay, to the next person, anybody? Guys, open floor.
From the audience.
Thank you. Well, my question is that when you're saying that you guys will provide for the UMP students, for the college community students, and for the HICOM student, so we get it. You are providing us for those ways for the uses of raw materials and all. The question is whether the consequences or disastrous consequences that will happen if somehow, for instance, UMP students and the providers, you guys. So is there any third party involvement between the road section, between us and those you, the providers, or who are responsible for the ones in between us? And who will be responsible for the road section between us, and what will happen, and what we'll do, what are the initiatives that you guys will carry on if anything like that happens.
Okay, any more questions you all have?
No.
Okay, since we have answered all of your questions, I would like to say our main objective again, what has my partner said before. Our main objective is to help the students from University Malaysia Pahang and HICOM and also college community. And not only that, we want to help the earth by reducing the waste products, because there's too much of plastics in today's world and it's destroying a lot of people's life. So, and we are supporting the sustainability as well. Okay, so I would like to finish our...
We
would like to end our conference today. Thank you for coming today.